Mrs. Eddy also enjoyed pleasant moments entertaining friends who sometimes, to her delight, brought their children to meet her. One of these happy moments was a visit by her own grandsons, George and Andrew, who traveled east from the Glovers' home in South Dakota. On her birthday in July, they gave her a pin made of gold from their father's mine. Their grandmother gave each of them what she valued greatly, the Christian Science textbook. Newsmen photographed the boys, still holding their books. She kept the framed photo where she could see it often.
Many years later, while conducting research on the Glover family, biographer Jewel Spangler Smouse made several trips to see Mrs. Eddy's grandson, George, then in his 80s, and living at the old family cabin in South Dakota's Black Hills. At one point, she asked him about that visit with his grandmother at Chestnut Hill back in 1910. As George recounted the experience for me, it was evident that he was quietly reliving the visit and had done so many times, wrote Mrs. Smouse. "If you didn't say much, George," I said, "then what were you thinking?" As he sat there for a moment, just remembering, I saw that his blue eyes had filled with tears. There was another moment of silence. Then Mrs. Eddy's grandson replied quietly, "Why, I thought she loved me." In 1948, with his own children now grown, George Washington Glover III, a lifelong student of Christian Science, traveled back east with his wife for one more visit to Boston. After an early Sunday morning tour of the Christian Science Publishing Society, the Glovers attended the service in the Mother Church. That afternoon, they drove the few miles out to George's grandmother's home in Chestnut Hill, where, to George's surprise and delight, they were welcomed by Adelaide Still, who was present during the birthday visit almost four decades earlier. As he stepped once more into his grandmother's suite, George slowly scanned the room until his gaze fell upon her mantle. The picture taken all those years ago by the newspapermen was still there, enduring evidence of a grandmother's love.